Around the 24th of May, we're going to shut down at least half of our system. All public visiting will stop at that point. We will continue legal visits and professional visits, law enforcement visits. Approximately a week after that, on the 31st, all video visitation will stop, and we will only accommodate contact visits for attorneys and law enforcement. About the week of June 14th, we're going to be bringing the new system online. Again, that is our projected date. These are all anticipated dates that we've outlined according to our project schedule thus far. But we want to make sure that we're at least letting the public know ahead of time that there is going to be a shutdown. It's estimated for approximately 4 weeks, could be longer, could be shorter. The new video visitation system is going to streamline some things for us and the public. It'll allow a web-based scheduling and registration process where people can do it from home. They can schedule up to a week in advance. They have to schedule at least 24 hours in advance. That way they don't have to come down here and wait for hours on end to get in to see a loved one. They'll already be scheduled. They'll know what booth they have to go to. All they got to do, come in, go through the security checkpoint, check in with the CA, and wait for their time to start, and they can go directly to their booth. And we're going to a more open visiting schedule. Right now, every module is scheduled for a half-hour block at certain times, usually during the evenings or all day during the weekend. We're looking at going to a more open visiting schedule during free time hours. We're a 24/7 town, so we have people working different hours. That way, they can schedule to come down and visit at different hours based on their schedule. So it's going to benefit in a lot of aspects so that we don't have the lines and maybe spread our visiting out a little bit throughout the day. We're going to have 4 kiosks here within the facility that they can come down. If they don't have access to the internet, then go to the library. They can come down here and register and schedule on the kiosks. The kiosks are going to have both Spanish and English versions on them for the scheduling and registration. They'll also be able to come down if they want to get the general information off those kiosks, kind of like the one we have out here. We're going to be replacing the system we have out front currently and putting it on these kiosks. So it's basically one-stop shopping. If they want to know when a court date is or where the inmate's housed, they can check that out, and then they can register and schedule for the visit at the same time. And then if they just got done visiting, they can schedule on their way out the door for the next visiting time they want to come in. We're getting a more reliable, more up-to-date system. It's going to create accessibility for everybody, a little more time for people to come in. Overall, it's going to be a lot better for people, a little more convenient for people to use and have a scheduled time. We ask that everybody be patient, but it will be a good system once we get it up and running, and it will be great for everybody to utilize.